This video concerns Strange's pitch windowing and chaos subsystems. We're going to start pretty abstract, with an internal clock, no quantizer nodes at all, 100% sustain, so a constant ongoing sound, and 100% portamento, so everything is smooth. Positive Rho therefore produces an upward saw LFO at the clock rate, but we might not want this to traverse the entire range, so I hold D and turn down X to reduce the pitch window size. When the rising pitch reaches the edge of the window, it wraps around, creating the saw. We can change that so that it reflects instead, creating a triangle, by holding D and turning Y anti-clockwise. Smaller windows are often useful for quantizer melody, and fold versus wrap is great for arpeggiator type work. We can even set a probability that the window will wrap or fold by setting a Y value somewhere in the middle. Slowing the clock will make this more obvious. And note too that it's the time taken to traverse the entire window which remains constant, so wider windows jump more notes. We can already see that with only positive Rho and a probabilistic fold wrap selection, we can already produce quite complex behaviour, and indeed, one of Strange's design goals was to make the mother of all random modules, a kind of make-noise maths for random. So it incorporates two interdependent chaotic LFOs. I'm going to bring one of them up on the scope in a red trace. The idea is to provide different kinds of complexity, which can be combined and interrooted to produce a final result more intricate, surprising, and ultimately musical than the sum of its parts. So let's route the chaos signal to the main Strange algorithm output with the chaos depth control. While useful for shaking things up, I'm leaving the speed and mod controls alone so you can see how chaos behaves when left entirely to its own devices. The entire Strange algorithm output in green follows the undulations of the chaos signal. In fact, more accurately, it's the entire pitch window that follows it, within which Strange's output continues doing whatever Rho, Delta, and Loop specify. Another important observation is that the chaos output is not only unpredictable at the micro scale. By definition, any random signal is. Much more usefully, it also exhibits wide fluctuations in its behavior on the macro scale, from stasis to quasi-periodic to wild fluctuations into the near audio. This is important for two reasons. First, it means that at higher frequencies, it will oscillate much faster than whatever Rho and Delta are doing, causing aliasing effects which serve to break up periods of predictable behavior with periods of flux and excitement. Second, it means we can use it to control higher order structural elements of a performance. We'll hear that in a bit, but first, let's dial down the window size so it has zero height. That is, Rho and Delta will do nothing, and the movement we're hearing is completely due to chaos moving the window position. Now suppose we route chaos not to the window, but to Rho and Delta. I hold D and turn Z anti-clockwise. All movement ceases, but when I turn up the window height again, although the window itself remains static, the positive Rho signal within it is bent and deformed by the chaos signal. Technically, chaos in fact now graphs your melody's rate of change, the melody by dt. It also, of course, remains subject to whatever fold or wrap settings you have dialed in. So much for complex LFOs. Now let's place this within a more traditionally tonal context. I switch to external clock. Remove all the portamento. And punch in a C Lydian, manually this time, without using a preset. With no chaos, the constant positive Rho produces a pretty, if slightly repetitive, rising scale over the low pedal note drone we've had playing for context since the start. I switch the window from wrap to fold so it reflects the melody. And now set that to be more probabilistic, so sometimes it folds and sometimes it wraps. I reset the chaos routing so it's post-window rather than pre. That is, it moves the whole window rather than the window's contents. And now I apply it, about 50% depth. The final melody therefore moves stochastically within the window, sometimes wrapping, sometimes reflecting, and chaotically without, tracing in its entirety the macro and micro undulations of the chaotic source, a stochastic complex in the Lydian mode. Listen for the hidden relationship between the delay feedback in the harmony part, controlled by Strange's external chaos output, and the contour of the melody, both shown in the red trace. Entirely unassisted, Strange is taking care of both its own melodic output and more structural aspects of the performance, like the control of the sonic effects in the accompaniment. From rapid glitching to slow fades, which, as is the nature of chaos, suddenly change direction at the last moment. There, it's all about serendipity, listening for and responding in performance to moments of magic.